Hello everyone, I am Nishant. So I am here to discuss the strategy about last year's history question in anthropology. So we had a question in paper 2, the question 4b. The question was like this: describe various aspects of Harappan trade and religion. So we will try to understand what is trade and what is religion separately, and how Harappans traded, and what was the kind of religion Harappans followed, and we'll try to conclude these points, that is, what are the different trade aspects of Harappans, what was Harappan religion, and what are the inferences we can draw from the trade, and what was the religious continuity as such, if the religious continuity really existed or not, and we'll try to compare the Harappan civilization with the contemporary cultures. So when we are asked to describe about Harappan trade, we are broadly expected to touch these aspects in our answer. So first we'll try to understand what is Harappan trade. So Harappan was obviously an urban civilization. We all know that Harappa was an urban civilization which was depending on rural surplus being sent to urban towns. It was being sent to urban towns, and the entire Harappan civilization model depended on this kind of relation, and it flourished for more than 800 to 900 years purely based on this model. So by and large, Harappan trade was internal as well as external. So for a long time, historians emphasized a lot on external trade of Harappans. But when we look at internal trade, the very internal trade of Harappans was very significant in establishing the continuity of the civilization. Recent historians like Upendra Singh emphasize more on internal trade of Harappans. And first we'll try to understand the internal trade of Harappans. Harappans, as we all know, it was a Bronze Age civilization, and bronze is made up of copper as well as tin. So when we see these two metals, that is copper and tin, Harappans traded copper with K3 mines. They received copper from K3 mines in Rajasthan, and tin they received from Afghanistan and Haryana. So this was their trade. And there, as we all know, there was no coinage system during Harappan time, and by and large, internal trade was barter trade. So the entire trade was a barter system, and they traded even gold with Kolar area in Karnataka. And this was a Neolithic culture then. It was a Neolithic culture. The entire Karnataka was under Neolithic culture, and we can see that India is a very geographically diverse country, and the northwestern part of India, that is Harappan culture, was under Harappan civilization, while the southern region and areas like Karnataka and Tamil Nadu, present day Karnataka and Tamil Nadu, were still under Neolithic civilization. And then Harappans also had a lot of exchange of their seals, carnelian beads, and also another seals called terracotta seals. Terracotta is a substance made up of heating of clay. When you heat clay continuously, you find the terracotta seals are formed. So by and large, the internal trade of Harappan was based on these parameters. The internal trade was a barter system, and it was based on the exchange of seals, carnelian beads and terracottas. In some Harappan sites, we find some evidences of bull carts. So this comes to show that the internal trade must have happened via bull carts, where we find some kind of excavations in sites like Harappa and Mohenjo-daro, we have the evidences of bull carts. So this is broadly about internal trade of Harappa. Now we'll come to external trade. So we have extensive research on external trade of Harappa. Harappa, as per historians, broadly traded with these areas, that is Mesopotamia, Persia, Oman. So how do we know that Harappa has traded with these three areas? We have some excavations of Harappan seals, carnelian beads and terracotta in these areas, and also in some Harappan sites like actual Harappa, Mohenjo-daro. We have some remains of Mesopotamian, Persian and Oman culture as such. So what we try to conclude is there was some external trade during Harappan system, and the external trade by and large was through sea routes. And sea route, and when we say sea route, so this pulls us to a conclusion that Harappa was good at naval or sea infrastructure. They had good boats and other equipment in place, so that they had extensive trade with external regions like Mesopotamia, Persia and Oman. And other reference of trade of Mesopotamia with Harappa comes from Mesopotamian inscriptions, where they refer trade with Meluha. As per Mesopotamian inscriptions, Meluha is a place which is eastern side of the Mesopotamia, that is present day Afghanistan and the entire Harappan civilization. But the historians also vary on this fact that Meluha might be a general reference of eastern region, but not exactly Harappan as such. And historians also debate the point that Mesopotamians might not have directly traded with Harappans, but through some merchants. But the point is still being researched, and we are yet to come on the conclusion on the trade part. So this is about Harappan trade, and now we'll come to Harappan religion. Harappan religion. As we know, Harappa is still being researched by historians and scholars to a very extensive extent, but at the same time historians still have lot of questions about Harappan religion. Harappan religion cannot be attributed to any kind of Vedic religion or any kind of cult as such, but the first historian, James Marshall, found that Harappans worshipped female deities. There are lot of female figurines which are found at various Harappan sites, and what the historians conclude out of female deities is they worshipped female deities for fertility. Because historians try to conclude that Harappan was a agricultural civilization. As we initially discussed, Harappan entire model was based on rural surplus being delivered to urban, and the entire model was sustained on it. In fact, we have a theory which says that Harappan civilization declined because this link broke. So one of the theory says that Harappan civilization actually got destroyed because there was not enough surplus to give to urban areas. So historians try to connect these two links, saying that since Harappan was an agricultural civilization and female deities were worshipped for fertility reason. And then we also have various archaeological archaeological evidences which show that Harappans had phallus worship. Phallus worship, or the present day what we call the linga or yonis. There are many evidences at various sites which are referring to these kind of lingas or yonis, which present day we call as lingas. And also there was one special seal, and this seal holds significance in understanding the Harappan religion. That seal is called Pashupati seal. In that Pashupati seal, what we see is there is a character which is a mythological character which is surrounded by animals like bulls, snakes and other animals. And what historians feel is this Pashupati seal of Harappan time is related to Rudra of later Vedic age and modern day Shiva. So this way we are trying to infer if the Harappan religion actually passed on to modern day Hinduism. And also we have a seal of unicorn who is considered as God, and this unicorn is a mythological character, and there are lot many seals especially in the area of Mohenjo-daro and Harappa where this kind of unicorn seals is unicorn seal which is a mythological character is present. And lastly we will try to understand the cemetery practices and the funeral practices of Harappa. So it comes under the religion only. So the body of dead was buried in a north faced way, which is very much the modern day practice in Hinduism. So the body was north faced and the remains of the dead were buried along with the dead. Remains of the dead were buried along with the dead, and this is also practiced in some castes in Hinduism today. And some cases the burial was not practiced but the body was exposed to natural elements, and when the bones remained those bones were buried. As we know, even today some castes in Hinduism burn the body and collect the bones and then try to mix them in the water. So this is about Harappan civilization, that is trade and religion. Now these are the factual things. We will try to infer these questions from our discussion, that is what are the trade aspects. So if you see the Harappan trade, we can conclude few important points. That is, Harappan trade actually expanded. That is, if you see the Harappan trade, it was there at Shartugai, which is in modern day Afghanistan, and Surkota then, which is in modern day Iran. This itself shows the expanse of Harappan trade, and also in fact we are talking about areas like Kolar which are in deep south. So this shows that Harappan had a very extensive trade relations both internally and externally, and it actually describes the healthiness of the economy during its peak. Harappan had a very good healthy and a good economy when it was at its peak. And the next is Harappan religion. So there is lot of research even now which is going on where historians debate if the Harappan religion has actually is actually a ancient form of Hinduism, and did some of the rituals of Harappans pass on to modern day Hinduism. As we can see at some places like Kali Bengan, which is an Harappan site, we find fire altars. So what historians say is fire altars are very much referred in the Rigvedic time. In fact, many of the Rigvedic prose hymns are based on fire altars and yagnas. They invoke Lord Agni towards fire altars. So as we see, these fire altars are present in Kali Bengan, which is an Harappan site. So what historians debate is Harappan religion or Harappan civilization did not extinguish once for all as such, but the Harappan priests, they continued in the Vedic religion in the Aryan phase as well as in the later Vedic age. So that is one inference which we can draw from this Harappan religion. And as we discussed, what are the inferences through trade? Inferences through trade is Harappan civilization was obviously very broadly expanded and the trade was very much flourishing at its peak. But also what we come to know is Harappan culture was diffusing. That is, when we talk about extreme places like Shartugai, which is in the northwest of Afghanistan, and Surkota then, which is at the bottom of Iran, that means the cultural superiority of Harappans is very much established from the trade aspects of Harappan religion, Harappan civilization. That is, the culturally Harappan was pretty much probably superior. We can just guess saying that Harappan's culture was probably more superior to compared to the contemporary civilizations, right? So, and then obviously we have discussed religious continuity, which is still debated through funeral practices of Harappa and also the religious practices of Harappa. That is, Pashupati seal, which we attribute to modern day Rudra and Shiva, and also the north face burials, which is very much prevalent in the modern day society as well, and also burying the remains of dead. And also if you see the later Vedic age, we still feel many female deities arising. And there is one separate subject called Tantriism, which is completely based on female deities. So what historians feel is Harappan civilization has actually continued into the later Hinduism, and this was, and they attribute all these things to the later age, later religious rituals. And the last thing is comparison with contemporary cultures. We see that India is a very geographically diverse and expansive country. So it is, we cannot say that Harappan civilization was even present in the south, because when the Kolar, Harappa was trading gold with the Kolar region, what historian have noticed is Kolar region is still in Neolithic age, that is one age before Harappa. And probably it is, and some ages in the eastern side of the India were still under Chalcolithic age, that is Copper age. But when you see Harappa, it is a Bronze Age civilization, that is, it is in a much matured phase of the civilization, and it is obviously more comparable, in fact more superior and advanced when compared to trades in civilizations within India. But when it comes to comparison with civilizations outside India, by and large many historians are still silent if Harappan civilization is actually superior to Mesopotamia or not. But one thing we can conclude, Mesopotamia was also an urban civilization, very much similar to the Harappan civilization, and overall this is what we can infer. And there are two factual things, that is, though Harappan religion had some link with, has some link and some resemblance with the Vedic religion, there are no temples in Harappan age. There is absolutely no reference for temples in Harappan religion. And also there is one important aspect, there is a debate of whether horse was present in Harappan civilization or not, because few feel that horse carts were used for trade. But historians still debate. Harappans only know about the horse, but they did not use horse as such, and even the remains of horse are only at some site in Gujarat, which is called Surkot Tada. Here some horse remains are found, but Harappans by and large did not trade using horse carts, they used only bullock carts. So when we write the answer, we are supposed to touch these broad aspects, and with special emphasis on these inferences will be the final answer for this question. Thank you.